that something's happening and it's serious. I want to write it down because I feel that time passes and people forget. And if you write it down, they don't. So sometimes I feel like I have to be that person. So I thought, I have to write about it. I have to start writing about it before it lands into the coast of New Orleans. Because I have to get this thing going. So I start writing my poem. And then I'm like, well, you can't, as a writer, you can't write a horrible, depressing dirge about a city that's just about to get hit by a hurricane, and then expect in 10 years for these people to go like, oh, that was such a beautiful, totally depressing, miserable piece of writing. Why did you do that? And so I'm going, okay, we have to look at it another way. So I have to attack this. I have to think about how this is really going to be. I have to be aware that, first of all, New Orleans is not going to go down. I'm painting the picture right now. It is going to survive. They're going to get most of the dogs out of the house. They're going to get, lots of people are going to survive and come back to New Orleans, and they're going to rebuild their houses. And the music is going to still play, and you're still going to get to go to New Orleans and spend a magical weekend. And it's going to happen because I say so. And then I got some music, a really beautiful track, and I put it, by now it's almost here. By now I get the track, I put it on the cassette to the recording player, and I sing it, and it's really, I think it's really good, and it's really sensitive and compassionate and scary. But, okay, so I put it in the gothic trunk of rock songs, and I sit there and wait for the hurricane, and I watched it for days and days. And I have lots to say about it that I didn't put in the song. You know, like, where was the government? Where were the people? My dad used to be president of Greyhound. My dad had been alive. He would send all those Greyhound buses in and gotten all the people. So anyway, the song was done. I put it away. And I never played it on stage. I went on the, I recorded it for Interviews in 2010. Didn't do it. Went out on the road for 2 years. Just couldn't do it. But this tour, I thought, you know what, I think it's time to share this with people because it means a lot to me, and I hope it will mean a lot to New Orleans someday. So this is called New Orleans is a Good Place.
I'm not afraid.
Thank you.